What's going on, friends? Just want to say Merry Christmas from my family to yours. Man, as I'm jumping on social media and just seeing all of the beautiful families and the pictures of the kids, and I can just see all the joy and excitement, and it's an awesome sight to see. This time of year is the time of year that we celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus. It's a time to remember the gift that God gave us by sending his son to this earth on that ransom mission over 2,000 years ago. A ransom mission. Man, that sounds intense. Well, because it is intense. Think about this. Jesus, the perfect, sinless Son of God, stepped out of the heavenly realms into this broken place to pay the price that only he could pay, to free us from slavery and captivity. Yes, my friends, we are slaves to our sin and we need a savior. And it was in Isaiah chapter 9, 700 years before Jesus's birth, that Isaiah prophesied about this child that would be born to us, a son that would be given to us, and that the government would rest on his shoulders, and he would be called the Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Prince of Peace. But sadly for a lot of us, this is where it stops. And I was in the Word this past week, and it was Matthew 26 and 27. And this is the point when Jesus had been arrested. He had been wrongly and illegally tried, beaten, mocked, beaten again, spit on, falsely accused, beaten some more, flogged, tortured, led like a lamb to the slaughter, to the cross, to die for you and me. As I walked through this week of Christmas, the Lord spoke to me in a very real way. And he showed me that I tend to compartmentalize the story of Jesus' life, when in reality it's truly just one story. I know what all of you are thinking at this point. Salim, it's Jesus' birthday, it's Christmas, you're jumping ahead to Easter, and yes, but here's the bigger point. The greatest gift that we could have ever received was Jesus. Today is the day of his birth, and that is absolutely amazing, but what's more amazing is why he came, and that's the point I'm trying to make. This is the biggest gift, the gift of salvation, because of the blood he shed and his life that he chose to lay down for you and for me. Guys, I mean, I sit before you super convicted, because I tend to get into this Christmas mode, and it's all about gifts, and it's all about my kids, and it's all about what are we gonna eat, and what are we gonna drink, and how many parties are we gonna go to, and man, we get so lost in all of that. And the point that I wanna make is that, you know, as we celebrate this day, let us focus on the real reason for the season. And let's push Santa to the side for a minute and take a moment to take in the real truth behind Christmas. And let's focus on the totality of what God gave us when he sent Jesus into this world as that baby who grew up to be a man that would go to the cross and give his life as a ransom for you and for me. That is the story behind Christmas, and that is the bigger gift. Merry Christmas to you guys. I love all of you, and I hope that 2020 brings amazing things for you all.